what is the best 3x3 on the market right now? Today, I will be comparing what I believe are the three best magnetic 3x3 cubes on the market right now to see which one may suit your personal preference. The three cubes that I will be comparing today will be the flagships of two 3x3 manufacturing giants, Moyu and Gen. We have the Gen 356XS and the Moyu Weilong WRM. I've also added in my current main, the Dian Tengyun V2M. As for the Valk 3 Elite, well, I don't have that. First off, comparing the size of these cubes. The Gen 356XS is 56mm, the Tengyun V2M is 55mm, and the Moyu Weilong WRM is 55.5mm. Each of these cubes differs in size, but in my opinion, 1mm doesn't really make a massive difference in 3x3, and size only starts to make a big difference in 3x3 when you're about less than 54mm or more than 57. As for the price, these cubes actually differ quite a bit. At $31.95 USD, the Tengyun V2M is the cheapest out of the three cubes that I will be comparing today. The Moyu Weilong WRM has a price tag of $38.95, which is the middle price out of these three cubes. And at $60, we have the Gen 306XS, which is by far the most expensive cube out of these three. Gen tends to make premium puzzles with a hefty price tag to match it. So, at $60, the Gen 356XS definitely has much higher expectations to live up to. So now taking a look at the customization, first off with the Gen 356XS. For the Gen 356XS and the Tengyun V2M, you can adjust three things: magnet strength, centerpiece travel, and spring elasticity. For the Moyu Weilong WRM, you cannot adjust the magnet strength. As for ease of use, I think the Tengyun V2M is the easiest to use out of these three. The Gen 356XS sometimes requires your hands, and that can be really painful at times. So, I think the Dian Tengyun V2M is the best in the customization department. If you don't know how to customize any of these three cubes, I made reviews and customization tutorials for all three of these cubes on my channel, and I will leave a link to all three tutorials in the description below. Taking a look at the corner cutting, there's actually a bigger difference than you might expect. The Gen 356XS and the Tengyun V2M actually corner cut a little bit more than the Weilong WRM. The Weilong WRM has this spot in between reverse and forward corner cutting where you will not be able to corner cut. The Tengyun V2M and Gen 356XS corner cut from almost everywhere, so when you are doing algorithms that require lots of corner cutting, it tends to be able to do that better, whereas on the WRM sometimes it won't be able to corner cut. In addition, the Moyu Weilong WRM's corner cutting is much more forceful than the Dian Tengyun V2 and the Gen 356XS. So, all these cubes have merit, but each do have their own pros and cons. In my opinion, the Gen 356XS is more effortless to turn, and I experience much less friction between each turn. The Moyu Weilong WRM has a very smooth feeling to it, and while it is not as effortless to turn as the Gen 356XS, I personally think that this cube is a joy to solve on. As for the Tengyun V2M, this cube is more stable and controllable than the other two cubes. However, the downside is that it is not as fluid and effortless to turn as the other cubes. Now, although customization can change the feeling of these cubes, I feel that you can only customize cubes to a certain extent, other than the Tengyun V2M, which can be basically customized to any feel. And while I did say that this is more stable and may not be as fluid, you can definitely change this to make it faster. Whereas for the other cubes like the Gen X, I feel like the customization can only change the feel to a certain extent. Like the Gen 356XS, you can't really customize it to make it super stable. As for each cube's shortcomings, the Tengyun V2M does corner twist slightly more than I would like it to. And the Gen 356XS is sometimes uncontrollable due to its super fast speed. The Moyu Weilong WRM seems to lock up a little bit more due to its worse corner cutting compared to these other two cubes. So, here's the summary. As for my final verdict, I believe the Tengyun V2M has the best price to performance value. At $30, it is the cheapest out of all these three cubes and definitely performs as well as, if not better than, these other cubes. The Gen 356XS is fantastic if you have a light turning style and like practicing for long hours, as its effortless turning makes your hand feel less tired after long sessions. The Moyu Weilong WRM is a great cube if you love cubes with smooth turning. The Tengyun V2M is really quiet and is amazing for cubing in public. Personally, I believe that all speed cubes nowadays are pretty good. But if you do have a certain preference, then you should be able to choose the one that is right for you, as there's such a wide variety of cubes on the market right now. Apart from the cubes featured in this video, there are also plenty of other great speed cubes, which makes it hard to not find a cube that works for you. Today, I compared what I believed are the three best and most popular cubes on the market right now, and I definitely recommend them. You can buy these three cubes using the links in the description below. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.